Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem for a beam shown in figure. Here is the question. Draw SFD and BMD for the beam as shown in figure. Here the beam is given. Now just by looking at this beam I can say that it is a cantilever beam. And when we have a cantilever beam, it is fixed at one end and free at the other end. At the same time, in this problem, cantilever beam is loaded at the free end, the load value is P. Then there is another load which is acting from the downward direction. It is going up like here at point B. So there are two forces, one P which is acting downward at point C. Next, another value of force P which is acting at upward at point B. The location between B to C, that is small a, and the length of the beam is capital L. Point A is fixed. For such a beam, we have to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. Let us get started. Now step number one is calculation of support reactions. At point A, the beam is fixed. Whenever we have a fixed beam, at that location, we have three kinds of reactions. First, horizontal reaction, which is here at point A, HA. Then there is vertical reaction, called as RA. It means for a cantilever beam, it cannot move in horizontal direction at the fixed location. It cannot move in the vertical direction at this fixed point. At the same time, there is a moment at point A. It means this cantilever beam cannot rotate about point A. So as we see, there are three kinds of reactions. Next, we'll have to find their values. Horizontal reaction at A, this reaction will be there only if there are horizontal forces. So here, as we see, there are no horizontal forces. HA value will be zero. So the horizontal reaction at point A is equal to zero. Then for vertical reaction, I'll use the condition of equilibrium. Summation of Fy is equal to zero. Upward forces are positive, downward forces are negative. So therefore, here we have RA acting upward, that is a reaction at A, vertical reaction. Then we have plus P, it is acting upward, then minus P is equal to zero. So therefore, reaction at A will be equal to zero as this plus P minus P gets cancelled out. It means there is no reaction at point A. Then summation of moment about point A will be equal to, here my convention is clockwise moment will be treated positive and anti-clockwise moment will be treated as negative. So I want to find the moment at point A. So this will be P into L, clockwise, so positive, P into L. Then minus this P, because it is producing anti-clockwise moment, minus P into, and the distance will be, since this is L, this is A, this distance will be L minus A from A to B. So that will be into L minus A. So it is equal to PL minus P into L, if I open the bracket, minus and minus, that will be plus P into A. So here plus PL minus PL gets cancelled out. So the value of moment at point A is equal to P into A. Next, this completes the step number one. Now step number two is SF calculation, that is shear force calculations. So in the SF calculations, I'll draw the sign convention first. If a force is acting to the left hand side of section in upward direction, to the right hand side of the section in downward direction, both are treated positive. If there is downward force on the left hand side of section, upward force on the right hand side of section, both are treated as negative. So here, in case of cantilever beams, we have to start the SF calculation from the free end. So therefore, SF at point C will be equal to, now here we have point C, so shear force at this point, I'll take the section very close to point C. If I take the section to the right of C, there are no forces on the right hand side, so at first the value is 0. Now if I take the section to the left hand side, then on the right hand side of this section, here we have P which is acting downward, so any force which is there on the right hand side in downward direction is positive, so that is plus P. The unit is not given, so I'll just write down it is plus P. Either it can be Newton or in terms of kilonewton. Next, SF at point B will be equal to, as there are no forces present between C to B, the value of shear force will remain constant up to point B. So again, this will be plus P. And another value will be there of shear force at point B, that is if I take the section to the left of B, then on right hand side we have this P as positive because it is to the right and downward, so plus P, and this P on the right hand side upward is negative, so plus P minus P will get cancelled out and the value will be 0. So these are the two values at point B. Then after this, shear force at point A will be equal to, as there are no forces present from B to A, so the shear force which we get at point B, that is 0, we can say that on the left hand side of B, that will remain constant up to point A. So SF at point A is equal to 0. After getting these values, we can plot it onto the diagram. So I am drawing the beam diagram again. So now here I'll complete this diagram. So for the shear force diagram, first I'll draw the horizontal line which indicates zero shear force value. at point C the value is plus P, so it will be acting upward. Then between C to B, this value will remain constant because there are no forces from B to C. Then at point B, there are two values. One is plus P, other is zero. So after reaching the value of plus P, this value will go up to zero. And then at point A, the shear force value is zero. So from B up to A, the value is zero. So this is positive, and only this much is the shear force diagram. So here we complete the step number 2. Now step number 3. Bending moment calculations. Moment at point C that will be equal to 0 because it is free end for a cantilever beam. Moment at the free end is 0. Moment at C is equal to 0 since it is free end. Then moment at point B is equal to, for that I'll draw the convention first. Now clockwise moment on the left hand side of the section, anti-clockwise moment on the right hand side of the section, both are positive. Next, anti-clockwise moment on the left side of the section, clockwise moment on the right side of the section, both are negative. So here if we see point B, and if I want to take the moment on the right hand side of B, that will be P into A acting in the clockwise direction. So clockwise moment on right hand side is negative. So minus P into A will be the value of bending moment at point B. Then moment at point A will be equal to, again on the right hand side section of A, this P into L will be clockwise, so that is negative, minus P into L. Then this P, which is acting in the upward direction at B, it will produce anti-clockwise moment. So on the right hand side, anti-clockwise is positive, so that will be plus P into, the distance is L minus A from B to A. This distance is L minus A. So therefore, on calculating this, minus P into L plus P into L, this will be minus P into A, if I open the bracket here, then minus PL plus PL will get cancelled out. So the value of moment is, moment at A is equal to minus P into A. So after getting the moment values at all three points, I can plot them onto the diagram. This indicates zero value of bending moment. So at point C the value is 0, at B it is minus P into A, so minus means it will go below this line, minus P minus P into A. This value of bending moment will remain now constant from B to A. At A the value is minus P into A. So that will remain constant. And finally it will reach up to zero because on the left hand side of A there are no forces present. And then from B to C, shear force was a straight line, so bending moment will be an inclined line. And here if we see, from A to B, shear force was just a zero line. So whenever there is zero line in the shear force, bending moment will be a straight line. And hence, here the value is negative. So this is the bending moment diagram. And once we have completed both the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram, we can say that the problem is completed.